Is it all good, YouTube? It is. Mate, and welcome to Grey Wolf Fitness. Now you've seen the title, haven't you? Sue's put it up. What's the title, Sue?
Workout day two? No? I can't remember.
You know,
you
when
put
we,
me under pressure.
You know when we practiced it 30 seconds ago?
Yeah, well, I've thought about other things since then.
So, the title is Day Two, Calves and Biceps and the Ab Debate.
Oh, I forgot about that.
Yeah, that we were talking about 30 seconds ago.
I know.
And yeah.
Okay.
Was that a blonde moment?
Yeah.
Right. So for this routine, so yesterday we did the whole body, the big exercises, the squats, the push press, the rows. They're going to affect your central nervous system, going to affect your recovery ability. So today, it's a short workout of about 25 minutes, attacking the calves and the biceps. Obviously, the big emphasis on the superhero transformation is the arms. Now, normally, I would say, don't train the arms, concentrate on the big exercises. But for this transformation, I'm concentrating on the arms. I know! But once I've done the transformation, I'll be going back to my normal concentrating on the big movements. So we're training arms, possibly some weeks, four times. So for this routine, it's going to be the seated calf raise and the dumbbell curl. And I have another routine for the calves and the triceps later on in the week. But let's get on to the ab debate. Now, on Josh's routine, as what we can figure out, he did 15 minutes of abs, every day, which was basically 10 sets of hanging leg raises, 5 1-minute planks and...
Bicycles.
Now, for me, I think abs are made in the kitchen rather than training them. I'm all for doing core movements like the plank and the... landmine rotation, but I'm not big on hanging leg raises, crunches, that sort of thing. It's not my bag baby. So what I want you to tell me in the comments, what do you do for abs? Do you train them? Do you not train them? Do you agree with doing such a long ab routine every single day? Now this is the other point I'm getting on to. This routine that Josh did, not really feasible for the working man. It's all right if that's what you're doing, you're concentrating on getting ready for a movie part.
Or a competition.
I think it's a bit excessive for a competition as well, to be truthful. So for me, buying this $140 routine, and I think for anybody, would have been a waste of money because I think you would have been overtrained within a matter of days, never mind weeks. So let's get on to the routine now. But first, I was a bad person, Sue.
I know you're a bad person. What have you done now?
Now, on my original video, I said the only person to take up this challenge was Miles from Fat Over 40. But there's two other people, and he's gonna hate me for this, my good friend across the pond, Christian Durbin. The big strong man, the big power lifter, yes, he's doing the cable challenge. Unfortunately, or fortunately for himself, he's not over 40. He's going to help me. He's going to hate me for this. He's not over 45. He's a young'un, but he's doing the challenge. So I'm giving a special shout out to Christian. I know he's going to hate me for this. And also I'm going to put a link to his channel because he did a fantastic video. I think it was... If you're watching it today, it'd be yesterday, on motivation, go and watch it. He's got a fantastic channel. If you're into strongman, powerlifting, it's the channel for you. And the other mention, he used to do the YouTube channel, The Last Stop Home Gym. I'll give you a link to his channel. He's not put a video up for a while. It's a crying shame, but he's on Instagram as Jim, the regular guy, I think it is. But his link to his Instagram will be in his channel. So let's get into the routine. So it's just two exercises in this routine. We're starting off with a seated calf raise, and then we're moving quickly on to the seated dumbbell curl. So it's going to be a triple drop set. This is the last set of the eight sets. So we're starting off with the 17.5 kilos, down to the 12.5s, down to the 10s. Now I've only just moved up in weight on these, so it's, again, it's pure progression. I've finished off the last workout when I did this. It was 5 sets of 10 with a 16 kilograms dumbbell, so I'm going up in weight, dropping down to 6 reps, and then building back up to the 10 reps of 5 sets. So it's 8 sets in all. Now the warm-up for this I've done is just skipping and a few rotary cuff exercises. So the same weight on all the sets for the seated calf raise. And I've done 3 warm-up sets for the dumbbell curls. Get there some blood flow in there. So this is the last set of the 8. Are you ready, Sue?
Yeah.
Are you ready for some music?
Oh, what have you picked now?
It's the one that you told me to.
Oh,
don't be coy about this. This is Suzanne's pick, this. Are you ready?
You don't usually pick the ones that I tell you to.
I know, but... When it's time to party, we will party hard. The seated calf raise. The next time I do this rotation, I'll try for 12 reps, and then I'm going to be adding some weight. Again, pattern progression, got to be going, beating your previous best, that's what it's all about. So I know this was a quicker vid, but I'm just explaining my 5-day routine. So on that note, don't forget to like, subscribe, share. What else, babe?
Leave a comment.
Leave a comment, I'll catch you later this time.